Blackstone Publishing presents The Problem with Lincoln by Thomas J. DiLorenzo. This book is read by John McLain. To Professor Clyde Wilson, the very model of a gentleman and a scholar. Chapter 1. Unfounding Father. Great men are almost always bad men. Lord Acton. Under the spurious slogan of union, he moved at every point to consolidate central power and render nugatory the autonomy of the states. It is on his shoulders that the responsibility for the war must be placed. We all know his gentle words, with malice toward none, with charity for all, but his actions belie this rhetoric. This was Lincoln's pattern of war leadership. In the North, a repressive dictatorship. Against the South, the brutal meat-grinder tactics of unconditional surrender Grant and the brigand campaigns waged against civilians by Sherman. Were it not for the wounds that Lincoln inflicted upon the Constitution, it would have been infinitely more difficult for Franklin Roosevelt to carry through his revolution, for the coercive welfare state to come into being. Lincoln opened the way to centralized government with all its attendant political evils. Frank Meyer. As the quotation above, from conservative literary icon Frank Meyer, attests, it was once possible for conservatives to judge all presidents by their actions and not just the prettier words of some of their speeches. That all changed in the 1960s. When a segment of the conservative intellectual class joined with the leftist intellectual class to essentially deify Lincoln and censor virtually all criticisms of him, no matter how fact-based they might be. The left was honest about its motives in this regard. The late Kenneth Stamp, a former president of the American Historical Society, admitted that a rewriting of the history of Lincoln and the Civil War was being undertaken in the hope that it would bolster the welfare state and the civil rights policies of the government during the Johnson administration. From that point on, it would become more and more difficult for Americans to learn the unfiltered, unspun truth about our 16th president. The left has always championed centralized governmental power in the name of egalitarianism. Since Lincoln is more responsible than anyone else in American history for the centralized governmental bureaucracy that Americans have now lived under for generations, and because he is famous for his egalitarian rhetoric, he is wholeheartedly embraced by the left as a hero. The Communist Party USA even used to hold Lincoln-Lenin Day celebrations in New York City. The segment of conservatism that has done the most to obfuscate the history of Lincoln and the Civil War is the so-called Straussians, followers of the 20th century philosopher Leo Strauss, whose intellectual leader was the late Harry Jaffa, an expert in the use of rhetoric, the field of his doctoral degree from the University of Chicago. Jaffa's writings on Lincoln are almost devoid of historical facts. Instead, they are filled with instructions on how to properly interpret Lincoln's speeches. As Frank Meyer explained in an important essay in National Review, Jaffa celebrates Lincoln for his novel theory that America was founded not on freedom from governmental oppression and taxation without representation, on the rallying cry of "Give me liberty or give me death," but on the principle of the equality of individual persons. Members of what we might call the Lincoln cult, whether on the left or the right, routinely use ad hominem attacks to censor all criticism of Lincoln by insinuating that the critic is somehow a secret racist and even a defender of slavery. In a review of Judge Robert Bork's book, The Tempting of America, Jaffa himself compared the late Judge Robert Bork to Confederate President Jefferson Davis and John C. Calhoun. This was Jaffa's way of insinuating that since Judge Bork may have been a neo-Confederate, his views of the Constitution should be dismissed and ignored. Like leftist revisionism, the Straussian rewriting of history has been used to bolster a political agenda. If America is based on the principle that all men are created equal, that means all men everywhere. Therefore, it is morally right for the U.S. government to militarily intervene virtually anywhere in the world to bring equal freedom to the oppressed.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.